Yo, what is going on, Guardians? Mikowski here. In today's YouTube video, we're going to be breaking down some of the most recent PvP change announcements in part three of Luke Smith's Director's Cut. Now, in parts one and two of the Director's Cut, Luke Smith dove into how Armor 2.0 is going to change the way you play the game this fall when Shadow Creed comes out. But today, I'm just going to really focus in on part three, which goes over the Crucible changes. This is the first video I've ever made going over some of the breaking news and big changes coming into the Destiny universe and giving some of my thoughts on it. So if you enjoy the video, please leave a like, make sure you're subscribed, ring the bell, and leave a comment letting me know what you think of the upcoming PvP changes coming this September. This October. It's not that bad. 2 weeks. We'll make it. But let me know in the comment section what you think of the changes coming this Dude, I just did it again. I'm so hooked on the 17th. It's October 1st. News alert. Everybody who's listening right now, Destiny 2 Shadowkeep comes out on October 1st, 2019. There we go. I had to hear it for myself. But seriously, let me know. Let me know what you think of the upcoming changes and improvements coming to the Crucible. In this video, I'm not only going to cover the changes coming to the Crucible this fall, but I'm also going to lay out some of my wish list in addition to some of the really good changes that are coming to Destiny 2. Let's start out with the biggest news for PvP players like myself. Trials is still on hiatus. But, and not only is 3v3 returning to Destiny, but 3v3 elimination is coming back. Now, it's not going to be a fully fledged out playlist at first. Luke Smith actually says it's going to be pretty unpolished. There's no voiceover, there's no specific medals, but 3v3 elimination is back. With it comes four variants that Destiny is testing. Now, although 3v3 elimination will be very unpolished when it returns in October, and I quote Luke Smith, "We fully expect it to graduate out of labs and find a warmer home." Is that home trials? We don't know, but all we do know is that 3v3 elimination is back. Now, if you guys don't remember, the Crucible Labs were introduced a long time ago in Destiny 2, maybe even about a year ago, but it just never really took off. There's nothing to really test. There's nothing exciting about it. Nobody really bought into it. And it kind of just occupied this small part of the director that I don't even really think you would know was even there. But now with 3v3 elimination being used for the Crucible Labs, we are going to get to test out how trials could potentially work in Destiny 2, since it's a return of what we know and love to be an amazing trials experience, which is 3v3 elimination. So trials is not back yet. But we do get 3v3 elimination, which I know is something everybody from the Trials community is extremely excited about. Now, in addition to bringing back 3v3 elimination, Bungie is also bringing back two of my favorite maps from Destiny 1, Widow's Court, that is my favorite map, and Twilight Gap. Super exciting news there, as two of the original fantastic Crucible maps are returning to the Destiny universe. My questions are, though, will all maps be used to test elimination, or will they only be used for Widow's Court and Twilight Gap? Also, will we get Widow's Court and Twilight Gap for 6v6 too? I would imagine so, because as we know, every year around September, Bungie introduces three maps to the entire Crucible pool. Speaking of maps, Bungie is removing quote-unquote lackluster maps from the rotation. Please let it be Firebase Echo. Oh, Citadel. Oh, Equinox. Oh, get it out. And you know, the sad thing is those maps would be all right if it didn't take 15 seconds to sprint out of spawn. If you literally just eliminated the spawn points on those maps, they'd have a better chance. But because you're spending so much time in spawn and sprinting out of spawn on those maps, I would hope and assume that they're removing those maps at the get-go. Now, unfortunately, those three maps are all the new maps that we got with Forsaken, which means we really never got any new maps since Forsaken. But anyways, either way, Bungie is removing the more, let's just say, not fun maps from the rotation. It could mean more maps than just Firebase Echo and Citadel are being removed from rotation. It might also mean that they're keeping those maps. Maybe Bungie thinks those maps are great. We don't necessarily know exactly which maps will be removed from rotation, but it's safe to assume that some of the fan unfavorites in the Crucible will be taken out. I personally would love to see, in addition to this, a map veto and or map choosing section in the Crucible. We had this all the way back in Halo 2 and 3 where you could choose the best map and game type. But for now, I'm excited to see that Bungie has taken notice of some of the not so great map experiences in the Crucible. And we and we'll be looking to rotate those out with some of the better maps in the Crucible, in addition to hopefully Widow's Court and Twilight Gap. A lot of this update from the PvP perspective seems to be about finding Destiny's roots, and part of their roots are in 3v3 and 6v6 game types. Does that mean 4v4 is out? In other big Crucible changes, the quick play and competitive playlist are no more. In its place will be what Bungie's referring to as the Classic Mix playlist, a 6v6 arena playlist that focuses around Clash, Supremacy, and Control. In addition, competitive will no longer be 4v4. In its place will now be 3v3 survival only. Now, I wish it was just elimination, but we're getting that in the Crucible Labs, and since elimination doesn't seem like it's that fledged out yet, this makes the most sense. But even then, I'd really rather see Countdown even as opposed to Survival. And then even over Countdown, I think Clash would have been great for this, especially since that's what most of the Sweat community has gravitated towards as far as tournaments are concerned. Now, I think Survival is actually a pretty fun game type in theory. However, it's become a game type that is just riddled and heavily tilted in favor of whoever has the most supers and or heavy ammo. But wait, what's that? Changes are coming to super and heavy in Destiny 2 Shadowkeep? What? Tell me more, Mikowski. That is right, super changes are coming to Destiny 2 Shadowkeep. It appears as though we will no longer be getting killed twice by the same Dawnblader Striker, a huge win for all of us PvP players. Furthermore, super damage resistance will be nerfed. But does that mean we will be able to one-shot supers with snipers again? I really hope so, man, because even with box breathing, there are still some times where you will not kill that super with one shot. And what is more frustrating than hitting a super in the face with a 50 cal sniper rifle bullet only to be killed by him just a few seconds later? It is truly tormenting. And I know most, if not all, of the PvP community has been begging for this type of change for almost a year now. It's good to see that we're finally getting it in Shadowkeep. In addition to those super changes, orbs and kills will no longer grant as much super energy. I cannot wait for this update. Supers are a huge part of Destiny 2. I don't think that there should be any game type that doesn't include supers. I really think it has, like, it's what gives Destiny that MOBA feel. And in PvP, it's how we play out our power fantasy, right? Supers are supposed to be, well, super, but in the case of what we've experienced over the past year, they've just been too super, if you will. In addition to the super changes, heavy ammo changes were announced as well. In 6v6, heavy will now be communal, meaning all guardians on one team will be able to pick up heavy so long as they're close enough to the crate. You might be thinking when you hear that, holy crap, that sounds even worse than what we've been dealing with now, with just one player getting heavy. But less heavy ammo per brick will be awarded in 6v6. Now, my biggest question with heavy is, what about comp? What about elimination in the Crucible Labs? How is heavy gonna change there? Two ideas I had for how heavy should work in comp. Let me know what you think about these ideas. In one scenario, I think heavy should spawn twice a game. Once at the beginning to give teams a quote unquote objective to push towards, and once in the middle of the game to break up any stalemates. I do not think heavy should be involved at endgame. Too many times do games come down to heavy or supers at the end, and I'd rather see those moments determined by primary and special gunplay. And in the case that two heavy spawns per game in comp is too much, let's just go back to how we had it in Trials, where it spawned in the middle of the game one time and that was it. I'm okay with either option. I just personally want to see less heavy influence in competitive, which I hope will maybe be addressed in a later update. Skill match is being introduced, and it promises a wider variety of matches regardless of your skill level. Some matches will be, quote, tense and thrilling, while others should be stomps. Most importantly, not every game is going to feel like a sweat fest, which, if you've played quick play recently, it's essentially just turned into 6v6 comp. Guardians out here trying to get it in quick play, man. I'll tell you what, dude, you cannot take a break or chill. There is no chill right now in the Crucible. And it looks like skill match is going to help resolve some of the issues of always feeling like you have to try, like it's the grand finals of on the MLG main stage while playing quick play. Skill match will not only affect 6v6, but it'll also change how you earn glory points, making it so that losses are less punishing to your streaks. In addition to some of the Crucible news today, it looks like sweeping weapon changes and damage outputs will be coming this fall. Right now, not every weapon is viable in a competitive or even a Crucible situation, so hopefully some of the changes being made will allow a wider sandbox, a wider variety of playstyles and loadouts to thrive when Shadowkeep comes out this fall. My biggest takeaway from part three of Luke Smith's Director's Cut is how Bungie seems to be trying to resonate more with the community and the roots of the game while also applying what's worked since they switched up a lot of the foundation of Destiny with Destiny 2. So Bungie course corrected a lot from where Destiny 1 was in year 3, made changes, course corrected too far to the other side, and it looks like with Shadowkeep we'll get the nice middle ground from where the game's been, which should excite you as a Crucible player. There's a lot of good from Destiny 1, and there's a lot of not so good. If we can get a perfect combination of both, the Crucible is going to be in a great spot come October. I also love the return of 3v3. As Luke Smith says in the Director's Cut, Destiny is best enjoyed in factors of three. It's the way our fire teams have worked for 5 years. It's always been in a factor of three. And furthermore, it seamlessly allows us to move between strikes and nightfalls and raids and into comp and into classic. Fours just never really fit in the Destiny universe, which came as a total shock to me as a former Halo player who loved 4v4. Halo was just a perfect 4v4 game, but Destiny isn't Halo, and 3v3 has always worked better. Now, does that mean that 4v4 is completely out? You would have thought so by reading this director's cut, but towards the end, Luke Smith mentions that weekly rotators in the form of 6v6 and 4v4 will be coming this fall. So we'll have weekly rotators like Clash, Supremacy, Mayhem, Lockdown, Countdown. But why in 4v4? We've decided that it's not optimal in the Crucible in Destiny, so why go back to it? I'd much rather have Crucible have a laser-focused approach to the Crucible by utilizing factors of three and just forgetting about 4v4. And like I said, that's coming from someone who loves 4v4 game types. It just doesn't work in Destiny. That basically sums up all of the late-breaking news in today's Director's Cut, and it also breaks down some of my thoughts on what I read throughout the blog. Huge shout out to Luke Smith for the transparency and really just laying it out there for all of the community to read and see. I really hope we get to see more Director's Cuts. Not only is it transparent and provides plenty of information, it also kickstarts a natural dialogue about what we can do to make Destiny a better game. And I've always felt when the dev's vision collides and matches with what the community wants, within reason, that's when Destiny is at its best. And for the most part, Bungie has done an amazing job listening to the community since Destiny 2's not so great launch, and has completely turned this tanker ship around and put it on a course that's actually looking really promising. Now, in addition to some of the PvP changes announced today, I just wanted to quickly go through my PvP wish list for Shadowkeep. First and foremost, primary grenade launchers. What the? This is tough for me because I have thoroughly enjoyed Destiny Crucible every year. Through every change, every nerf, every buff, I have found a way to truly enjoy Destiny Crucible. But the primary grenade launcher meta is practically ruining it. I survived the sidearm meta of Rise of Iron. I survived the ammo nerf in Destiny 1 year 2. I even had a pretty good time in Destiny 2 year 1 when it was a double primary meta. But the primary grenade launcher meta has me at my wit's end, and I actually find myself trying to enjoy the Crucible right now instead of just naturally enjoying it like I have for many years. My biggest problem with primary grenade launchers is that they can one-hit opponents. I often find myself wondering, was that a mountaintop or a play of the game? Looking in the feed and seeing vice versa. Sometimes I'll get killed by a play of the game, think it was mountaintop, and then other times I'll think I got killed by a mountaintop, but it was actually the play of the game. Why are primary grenade launchers accomplishing what heavy grenade launchers accomplish when you have to wait to grab that ammo off the wall? You're essentially letting people spawn in with heavy. And this wouldn't be such a problem if primary grenade launchers couldn't one hit, but they could. And I could have sworn I read in an update that Bungie promised that primary grenade launchers were getting nerfed and could no longer one hit opponents. I don't know if it's because my resilience is too low or what, but regardless, I still find myself getting killed by one shot from a primary grenade launcher, and that simply should not be happening. And don't even get me started on the Fighting Lion and other grenade launchers that can trickle and bounce on every wall until they get to the end of the hallway and blow up in your face and kill you. If I wanted to just aimlessly look down a lane, I'd go play Overwatch. But I actually like to shoot my weapons with precision accuracy, which is another reason why the primary grenade launcher is just so upsetting. As a sniper, I have to earn my instant TTK critical headshot kill. For primary grenade launchers, they could hit me in the toe. Hell, they could bounce on the wall next to me and still take me down instantaneously. It didn't get discussed in the director's cut, and I really, really, really hope that Bungie takes a look at primary grenade launchers and considers maybe moving all of them into the heavy slot. Or just blow up the entire weapon arc. Just get them out. Just remove grenade launchers from the game. They do no good. They completely alter the balance of the Crucible right now, and it's actually something I'm extremely concerned about with Shadowkeep. How unfortunate would it be if we make all of these amazing changes to the Crucible and then we still have primary grenade launchers ruining the experience? Bungie, please don't let that happen. In addition to primary grenade launchers, something else that wasn't addressed in the director's cut that I would like to see addressed is the suicide penalty. Now, I was actually playing a game with Broski the other day, and we lost by 2 kills when the opponent jumped off the map 5 times. And I'm sure many of you guys watching this video have lost comp matches because of there being no suicide penalty. Now, I know with the upcoming changes to comp and 3v3 survival, there will, in essence, be a suicide penalty because you still lose your life. But still, in game types like Clash and Control, you need suicide penalties. We had those once again. They worked so well in Halo 10 years ago. I'm sure they'd work even better today to punish all of the people who jump off the map to avoid certain death. Now, speaking of Crucible modes like Clash and Control, we still have no Crucible modes. And I hate to keep going back to Halo, but game types like Oddball, Capture the Flag, King of the Hill, and even Assault would fit in perfectly well in Destiny. You guys all know how Capture the Flag works, but with the Assault game type, how it works is a bomb spawns in the middle of the map. It's up to each team to take that bomb from the middle of the map and push it into the opponent's base, plant it, and watch it explode. It is one of the most coordinated objective game types from the Halo series, and I'd love to see something like that make its way to Destiny. Now, with game types like CTF and Assault, these theoretically only work on perfectly symmetrical maps. Even a map like JAV4, which is one of the greatest Destiny 2 maps, isn't entirely symmetrical. In order for game types like CTF and Assault to work, Bungie would have to introduce more symmetrical maps, which I would hope to see anyways, because in my opinion, symmetrical maps are one of the biggest keys to success in map design. And outside of old favorites from Halo, how about old favorites from Destiny like Rift or Skirmish? Right now, we simply do not have enough game types. And while Supremacy is being added to the mix, the classic mix that is, it's still not enough. 3 game types I really don't think is enough to consider it a mix. You need, I think 5 would be like the, ooh, 5 would be the sweet spot in the classic mix. And in my opinion, would add up to a thrilling experience in the Crucible that never got old. For now, one can only hope, but I would love to see some more Crucible game modes introduced in Shadowkeep. And lastly, this one might surprise some of you guys because I am a sniper main myself, but what I would like to see in Shadowkeep is a nerf of 140 RPM sniper rifles. A sniper rifle is a precision weapon that rewards critical accuracy. The 140 RPM sniper rifles completely destroy that notion because you can just simply two-tap. I think Bungie actually had it right when they required 3 shots to the body. Right now in comp or quick play, there is no reason to use anything but 140 RPM sniper rifles. Bungie could do a great service to the 90 RPM and the 72 RPM archetypes by nerfing 140s back to where they were. Phew! Did you guys get all that? Oh my god. But hey, it's exciting stuff. We have plenty of new Crucible news to talk about. More changes will be announced before Shadowkeep. And of course, we'll discover more changes when Shadowkeep launches on October 1st. But for now, we have got quite the appetizer to chew on as we get ready for October 1st. Like I said, this is my first video ever breaking down the, you know, the biggest news of the day in Destiny. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, comment, make sure you're subscribed. In fact, more than 60% of viewers of this video aren't subscribed to the channel. Check and make sure you guys are subscribed. It goes a long way towards helping grow the channel. We are trying to hit 10,000 subs by Shadowkeep. And if everyone who watches this video and enjoys it subscribed, we can get there, Guardian. Let me know what you think of the upcoming changes to the Crucible. Let me know what other changes you'd like to see in the Crucible. And as always, stay positive, keep sniping, and we'll see you in orbit, Guardian.